I do soft tissue biomechanics, and in particular, I'm interested in how skin deforms in response to stretch, and then how it adapts to those mechanical cues, be it growth or wound healing, for example. One of the things that surprised me is that there is no tool currently to do this. Surgeons rely so much on their feel, on their manual estimation of what's going on. They know that the tension is important for the wound process, but they don't have tools to measure that tension. That's where I come in. Before the surgery, the patient would sit and then we take just a lot of pictures from different angles. And this can be done even with an iPhone, for example. The algorithms use that information to get a 3D geometry of the patient. The surgeon says, oh, this patient has this particular defect, we need to cut this out. Then we would do that in the computer model, and then we would stitch it according to what the surgeon would tell us is the right weight of stitching. And then that would be a virtual surgery. And out of that, what we would get is we would get these contours of the tension in the skin. And that can be helpful for the surgeon to see where is the tension the highest. Is there going to be a region that might be at a particular risk for complications? One of the advantages of doing virtual surgery is that you don't have to do one. We can get several options that the surgeon can then look at and decide which one would be the most adequate. Idea of predicting tissue behavior with computational models, it's likely to change the way devices are designed, procedures are decided. The advantage of skin is that it's a material, so it does obey mechanics. So you can use a similar set of tools that we have been using for designing buildings, for example. But yes, at the end of the day, they do obey the laws of physics.